I recorded a coaching session I had with a call center supervisor, and during the coaching session, I asked her why she wouldn't take an escalated call from me about a week earlier, and this is her explanation. I've altered her voice so you can't tell who it is, but keep in mind that this is only 6 minutes of a 20-minute conversation explaining to me why she wouldn't take an extremely irate customer from me off the phone who demanded to talk to a supervisor. And I wanted to give this example to each and every one of you so you can hear what kind of supervisors are actually staffing these call centers. So the call quality isn't the best, but this gives you a good example of what we all deal with as CSRs. Enjoy.
I was overwhelmed. I think, the day where you, or that week where you wouldn't take the call from me? You said you'd had enough of the customers and I had to go over and get Chad or somebody to take the call for me. It was a guy that was pushing me around. What's his name? The Jason, I think he sits over here.
I was working on multiple, that way you didn't have to wait though. I don't really.
Yeah, you said.
I was doing a lot of sassing that day.
You said, I think if I talk to him, I'll say the wrong thing and I'll regret or something like that. Go find Jason. So I scampered over there and I think, is his name Jason?
Yeah.
But he usually sits here, but he was over there with him. So he took it and I was just like, I'd had it off. I was just like, these customers, everybody was so awful.
And they were. But I hope I didn't impact that then.
No, I don't think so. It seemed like one call after the other. It was just like, you know, hey, can you speed it up, buddy? And, you know, what's wrong with you? And, you know, are you new? And I'm like, oh my God. It's like, you know, it's bad enough that I'm self-conscious on the phones. I'm getting more confidence, but it's just.
I'm sorry if I came across. I tend to do that too, to kind of keep it light. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And let you guys understand that I'm aware and that the feeling can be mutual, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And sometimes when you're the only person over here, I can't take every soup call because sometimes a soup call can last an hour. You know, like I spent 3 hours on the phone the other day just doing soup calls. Well, think about how many people I couldn't answer questions for that had to wait for DDA specialists because I'm now talking to a customer that just sitting there chewing that and there's nothing I can do. So sometimes it's better to, you know, and if there's a long hold time, so I have to make a split decision in that same respect. Right. You know what I mean? Like, I have to do what's best for me, I have to do what's best for you, and what's best for the customer. And if I wasn't in the frame of mind and the situation you told me, like, I didn't take one for Rachel the other day. She had to call DSS.
So, how come you guys take the call at our desk if the calls can extend another hour and drive over handle?
Well, depending on what they're for and stuff like that and the situation, they've got all of our phones working now. Like, I've been taking them at my desk.
Oh, you have? Oh, yeah. Your phones weren't working before?
Yeah. Well, we had to all get assigned phone numbers and, like, because we were in the new process, so they put us into it, but then we had to wait for all that stuff to trickle down.
I'm so sorry. I've been in the business for too long.
Right. So the idea is, you know, so now we're trying to pull them over here so that way you can just go into your next call.
Yeah.
And we're trying to keep them, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Kind of just one of those things. Sometimes we just have to make a decision and sometimes it can work and sometimes it can backfire.
Okay.
You know?
All right.
You know, that's where we're human too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know, make mistakes and, you know, like, obviously, that day I impacted that I didn't even realize I probably had.
No, I don't even know if it was the same day. It just was those 2 days for vacation.
And it really was.
Just like a hurricane and it was just.
And then I thought I'd watch the Twilight
Zone. Because I felt like, I was like, oh, I didn't even contact me. I was just like, nope, I'm going to go. I was like, okay.
No, I texted you. Derek.
Right.
I messaged you.
Right.
I just had to go.
So I didn't know if I had done something and then I'm guilty. You know what I mean? I'm talking to you as a guilty person.
Oh,
and that's where, like that thing, you know, how many times can literally somebody rip into you that many times before it does affect you? And you're like, I can't. I need a moment. So, and I tend to just try to be honest.
Yeah.
Instead of, you know, I'm not going to say, oh, well, the honest answer was I couldn't take the call.
Yeah.
I wasn't in the right.
Fine.
So, to make the best decision for company, customer, you know what I mean? And then, because of whatever I was doing that day, I just told you to run over so I didn't have to keep your hold time any longer.
Oh, okay. Sure. No, I understand what you're saying.
But you can always approach me, like, if you feel like I'm doing something or if I've made you uncomfortable.
No, you never made me uncomfortable.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
No, for example, Rachel, the one she had the other day, it was late, and I had literally just spent the last 2.5 hours on the phone with customers, getting my face ripped for no other reason than just to rip my face. And she said too many trigger words for me. And there was no hold time. It took less than a minute for her to get someone, and I had to have her give it to somebody else because she said he was intoxicated, he was belittling, and he was doing these things. So was it worth my personal feelings and everything like that to have someone? And there was nothing I could do for him. It's not like, if I can assist, but if it's just a matter of telling me how small I am just for their own personal sake, that's not necessary. And I don't let them do that to the other bankers. And I get very protective in that way. But at some point, a person just kind of needs to take a moment. And I was like, there's no way, can you please just call over? You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So I don't know. Some people don't just say those things. They just say, you know, well, you know, due to working on this or whatever. And we are always working on other stuff. But at the same time, I feel like it's good to know that we're all human and have those same feelings. There are just times where, because when I was a supervisor taking supervision, Tegan had to take a call from me one time, so I literally started to have a panic attack.
Yeah.
So what becomes the best solution? Do I stick with the whole, you can't have anybody else, this is the last word, this is the final say, and have it affect me so much emotionally and physically, or just finally break down and have somebody else help me? Just admit that I need help. That is something that the whole time I've ever been a manager, I'm not exactly the greatest at work. You know, people can have that stonewall face and I just don't have it. Like, you literally just see it, like, break down in front of me.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, no, I know. Yeah.
I just try to be as open and honest as I can. I just hope that people feel like they can be open and honest.